I don't know if I mentioned already. Don't think I did. But a tailor recently told me, more of a saying, but a well-made garment shouldn't need to be pressed. Just meaning that as we make, we should be pressing it before and after we use a piece. It gives the presser, or us, whoever, less work when doing the final press. Lay the back and front trouser inside to inside, and line the edge of the front trouser up to the mark-stitched edge of the back trouser, ignoring the sleesher. Line up the waistline, construction line and seat line, and the knee and hemline. We want to chalk those points onto the inlay so that we can see them and the front leg's marks at the same time. They may not line up perfectly, and I'm not entirely sure why, but it's most important to line up the waistlines. Everything else is secondary. Baste it in place, baste closely to the 1 cm seam allowance, but not on it. Moving the pocket bag out of the way, basting through the blind or big facing. What we need to remember is the flare we gave to the bottom of the hem. If you did it the way I suggested, there's the last mark stitch before it flares, but I guess we can see in the way that we cut it. Machine the two together. We're likely starting from the top with one and the bottom with the other. Regardless, when you get to the border of the blind and the rest of the front trouser, it's quite bulky, so be conscious that it'll try to push you away from the 1 cm seam allowance that we want. Making sure that we have the 1 cm seam allowance, the pocket will end in the side seam, as all trousers should. Don't back tack at the top or the bottom of the trouser. Remove the basting here and iron the machining flat. Then we need to check that yes, the bottom of the pocket ends in the side seam and there aren't any raw edges showing. We should press the seam open. We basically need to iron the flare separately because it doesn't sit flat with the rest of the seam. Similar to the point that the blind meets the front, we might like to put it on an edge board or plank of wood. Due to the unwieldy seam, it might be take a bit of oomph to press it down flat and make it stay that way. While you're at it, iron a 1 cm seam at the end of the pocket inlay. You could baste the lower half of it to the inlay, but don't fell them. Especially at the bottom of the pocket with the cumbersome seams, make sure that the stitch line is fully pressed open. I'd do the bar tacks and prick stitching at the ends of the pocket now, such that they're hidden underneath the pocket bag, but I didn't, saving it for finishing.